But back now to the second part of Bach's draft for a well-appointed church music, in which he details his ideal requirements where instrumentalists are concerned.
The instrumental band consists of the following: 4 or even 6 violins, 4 violas, 2 cellos, 1 double bass, 2 or 3 oboes, 1 or 2 bassoons, 3 trumpets, and 2 kettle drums, totaling 18 persons at least for the instrumental music, though the addition of 2 flutes often required makes altogether 20 instrumentalists.
Yet what Bach actually had at his disposal on a regular basis was a mere 8 players, 4 town pipers plus 3 professional fiddlers and 1 amateur. Well, I say professional, but as Bach discreetly put it,
modesty forbids me to speak at all truthfully of their qualities and musical knowledge. Nevertheless, it must be remembered that they are mostly elderly and not at all in such practice as they should be.
Nor was he much luckier at the opposite end of the age range. Many of the boys from whom he had to draw his choir were a liability, to say the least.
It cannot remain unmentioned that so many poorly equipped boys, and boys who have no talent at all for music, have been accepted into the school to date, that the quality of music has necessarily declined and deteriorated. And those who do bring a few precepts with them when they come to school are not ready to be used immediately as is required, for there is no time to instruct such pupils until they're ready to be used. And each year, some of those who have managed to accomplish something in music leave the school, and their places are taken by others who either are not yet ready to be used or who have no ability whatsoever. In conclusion, I must leave it to riper reflection whether in such circumstances the music here can continue to be maintained at all, or whether its still greater decline is to be feared.
And by way of a PS, he gives his assessment of the current crop.
17 usable, 20 not yet usable, 17 unfit.
It almost beggars belief. Here we have the greatest musical genius of the age, perhaps of all ages, occupying a supposedly prestigious position and confronting a situation which would drive many a lesser man to thoughts of suicide, or at least mass murder. No wonder Bach liked his drink. And no wonder that he had to get away now and again without waiting for official permission. His beloved Anna Magdalena and his ever-growing brood must have wished him godspeed every time. But the most extraordinary thing of all is that through all this he was fantastically productive, often churning out a whole cantata every week, among other things, and most of them masterpieces. It was here, in this job, that he wrote the Magnificat, the St. John and St. Matthew Passions, the B minor Mass, which many people regard as the greatest work ever written, and knowing all the time that he would probably never hear a halfway adequate performance of any of them. He simply wouldn't believe our luck today.